For over a century, Bryant has been a pioneer in home comfort. Our founder, Charles Bryant, has even been called the father of the gas heating industry. But who exactly was Charles Bryant, and why does the company he founded continue to endure? In 1877, the same year that Thomas Edison invented the phonograph, Charles Lester Bryant was born in Genoa, Ohio, a small village on the outskirts of Toledo. When he was just a boy, his father, a teacher, moved the family across the state to Cleveland, where Charles grew up. Technologically, it was a transformative time as the nation slowly began to make the switch from gas to electric lighting. After graduating from high school, Charles went to work as a salesman for the McIntosh Huntington Hardware Company. Having inherited his father's love of learning, he was fascinated by the mechanics he worked with and their solutions to regulating natural gas pressures. But in 1898, the Spanish-American War broke out, and 21-year-old Charles Bryant enlisted to serve as a private in an artillery division. After returning to Cleveland from the war, he picked up where he left off, and in 1904, formed National Gas Regulator with two of his McIntosh Huntington co-workers. The company sold high-pressure gas regulators to farmers who still used natural gas lighting. Those regulators reduced annoying whistles from the jets of flame and prevented pressures from cracking gas lighting globes. Their gas regulators were an instant success. As president of the new company, Charles Bryant then began to look for a way to use his company's knowledge of natural gas to heat homes and businesses. The answer was the tubular gas-fired hot water heater, and in 1907, Bryant and his partners formed the Bryant Heater Company. The following year, the company's design of the United States' first central heating system with the Bryant Boiler at its heart was eagerly accepted by local businesses. The company then began to slowly expand its geographic reach. By 1910, Charles Bryant sold his interest in this successful business, now called the Bryant Heater and Manufacturing Company, but remained as president until 1922. During this period, the company introduced a steady stream of new advancements. The Bryant Pressure Regulator in 1910, the Automatic Boiler Water Feeder in 1912, the first horizontal boiler in 1914. The same year, Bryant included a guarantee of 80% efficiency with its tubular gas boilers, and the first diaphragm control valve in 1915. Capping off these early achievements, Bryant installed America's first residential gas heating system in Denver in 1918. Just 4 years later, Charles Bryant left the company, taking 6 years off, then returning as president of a new company, manufacturing heating products, and later, stoves. This is where he remained until his death in 1945. During his remarkable life, Charles Bryant witnessed amazing technological achievements in the world around him. The flight of the first motorized airplane, the invention of plastic, and the first radio broadcasts. In the world of heating, his achievements were just as extraordinary. Although Charles Bryant never had any children, his legacy lives on in our company. It is with the same spirit we have continued to transform home comfort with advancements such as the first 90% efficient gas furnaces in 1981, the introduction of Puron, the first environmentally sound refrigerant in 1996, the industry's first packaged products in 2000, and captures and kills air filtration technology in 2015. Each year, we even honor the Bryant Factory Authorized Dealer that best embodies his qualities with the Charles Bryant Award. Charles Bryant, salesman, inventor, entrepreneur, a man who transformed home comfort by recognizing needs, developing solutions, and bringing a whatever-it-takes philosophy to everything he did. A man whose legacy continues to inspire us to be a leader in heating and cooling technology today.